Hello students of class 7, today I am going to do the chapter The Yellow Face with you all. And you have already heard about the name of Sherlock Holmes and his investigations and about his assistant Dr. Watson. So you are very much aware of this famous detective, and this story is based on his investigation only. So the story starts like this. One day, Sherlock Holmes and I returned to Baker Street at 5 o'clock after a brisk walk in the park. "Beg pardon, sir," said our page boy as he opened the door. "There had been a gentleman here asking of you, sir. Didn't you ask him in?" So one day, Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson, they returned to the Baker Street. Baker Street means it's a street in London where it is said that Dr. Watson and Sherlock Holmes shared their apartment with each other. So it is an imagination. It is said to be like that. Arthur Conan Doyle had written like that. And this story is in the version of whom? Dr. Watson. So one day Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson returned to Baker Street at 5 o'clock after a quick walk in the park. Then the page boy or the attendant boy who was there, he just said, or he begged for pardon as he opened the door, and he informed Sherlock Holmes that there had been a gentleman there asking for them. And Sherlock Holmes asked that if he had not told him to sit inside. "Yes, sir." He waited half an hour. He was very restless gentleman. At last he cries, "Is that man never going to come? I will wait in the open air. I will be back before long. And with that went. So the page boy or the attendant boy who was there, he informed that he had told the gentleman to sit inside the room. But the gentleman was very restless, and after waiting for some time, he became very exhausted. And he just shouted out and said that he was impatient. And he said that if Sherlock Holmes would never come to home again, or he wanted some fresh air. So he also informed that he would be back for long. So he wanted to go out and to enjoy fresh air. "It's annoying, Watson," said Holmes, as we walked into our room. "I was badly in need of a case. And looks from the man's impatient as if he were of importance. However, that's not your pipe on the table." Now, Sherlock Holmes became a little bit irritated, because at that time he badly needed a case, because with that case only he would be earning money. And he also found out that the man was very impatient, and he definitely wanted to engage Sherlock Holmes, and it was of great importance. Why? Because the man had left his pipe on the table, as it was not the pipe of Dr. Watson. He must have left his behind him. He must have been disturbed in his mind to leave a pipe behind him, which he evidently values highly. So Sherlock Holmes pointed out that the man was so impatient that he had left the pipe behind him, which he evidently was sure that he had valued the pipes very highly. It was of great value. The pipe was of great value to the man. Still, he had left the pipe on the table and left the place and went out to enjoy fresh air. So, I should put the original cost of the pipe at 7. How do you know that he values it highly? I asked. So Dr. Watson asked him that how Sherlock Holmes could know that he valued the pipe so highly. I should put the original cost of the pipe at 7 and 6 pence. Now it has, you see, been twice mended. Each of these mends done with silver bands must have cost more than the pipe did originally. So Sherlock Holmes pointed out that originally the cost of the pipe was very less, but the man repaired the pipe twice with silver bands. As a result, the pipe, the original cost of the pipe has rose highly. And it had the means it had become more costly than the original cost of the pipe. After repairing it with silver bands, the cost of the pipe was more than the original pipe itself. The man must value the pipe highly when he prefers to patch it up rather than buy a new one with the same money. So Sherlock Holmes pointed out that the pipe had a great value to the man as he had patched the pipe with silver bands. But he could have bought another pipe, but he didn't do that. He patched the pipe twice with silver bands. Why? Because he did not want a new one. He wanted to keep that old one because he values it very, very much. The owner is obviously a muscular man, left-handed, with an excellent set of teeth, careless in his habits, with no need to practice economy. If I am not mistaken, I hear him upon the stair. So what happened? Sherlock Holmes pointed out that, described the owner or the person who had left the pipe behind. He pointed out that the owner of the pipe was a very muscular man, means very well built, and left-handed, means he used his left hand, and with an excellent set of teeth. He had an excellent set of teeth. He was very careless in his habits and with no need to practice economy, because he was not at all calculative. He did not want to save money because he was very much affluent. He was rich and he was able to spend money as much as he wanted, if I'm not mistaken. So at that point of time, Holmes heard the man's footsteps upon the stair. So he pointed out that if he was not mistaken, he could hear the footsteps of the man upon the stair. An instant later, our door opened. A tall young man, about 30, entered. So a moment later, the door was opened and a tall young man, about 30, he was about the age of 30, entered there. "I beg your pardon," said he, with some embarrassment. "I should have knocked. The fact is that I am little upset. My whole life seems to have gone into pieces." He then sat down. So the man entered and the man begged his pardon from them. And he was a little bit embarrassed. He was a little bit troubled. And he thought that he should have knocked, but he didn't knock. He opened the gate and entered. And he said that he was little embarrassed that he had knocked the door. He didn't knock the door. And he was also a little upset. Why? Because his whole life had gone into pieces. Means he was extremely sad. And he then sat down. Then he sat down. "You wish to employ me as a consulting detective." So now Holmes asked if the man wanted him to employ him as a consultant detective or not. That Holmes asked the man. So you can understand that this man had come to Holmes to engage him as a consultant detective for a case.